Hey there, strangers. It's time for another 2 PM Peace Teacher stream. Sorry for the late arrival and me talking quietly right at the moment. My roommate is in a meeting currently, but at the same time, I'm not in the greatest of moods. Just saw a video that should kind of spread around the United States, because this is this infuriates me, and it should infuriate others. Makes me kind of wish that I did have some kind of political sway so that I can get the ball rolling to seek justice on this. Let me go to webcam here. I didn't really do any kind of cleanup or anything like that today. I was just so... There's a lot of things going on here in the States that has really been... disturbing, to say the least. First, there was the lady in New York Park that tried to get the police to go after someone that asked her to put her dog on the leash. Then it was the police officer that put his knee on an African American's neck for, it was, what, 10 minutes? I couldn't watch the video all the way. I really couldn't. It was disturbing. Don't get me wrong, all these videos that you see of people getting, people getting strangled by police officers that shouldn't be. And these officers get no repercussions from it. Now, I'm already aware that 4 of the police officers have been fired. I'm aware of that. But here's the thing. Not a single one of those officers pushed that cop off the individual. Didn't start CPR on him when he started having additional complications. Now, I put my faith in police, okay, because there are a lot of individuals out there that do serve and protect. A lot of them, okay. And I will stand up for every single last one of them that do right. Okay. You serve and you protect. You're in good graces with me. Okay, you're putting your life on the line to serve and protect me. Now, I know. A lot of people say you need to protect yourself. Believe me, I know. But the police are there as a preventative measure, and I appreciate those that do serve and protect. Okay? But here's the thing. For a police officer, you need to hold your coworkers to a higher standard. I mean, I can try, you know, by putting investigations out there, asking for inquiries, you know, getting more more movement on those kind of things, okay, but I'm not with additional police officers, okay? I don't influence them, I don't really talk with them, okay? You know, I don't really have any cop friends or anything like that, okay? But here's what I tell them. Call out those that you feel are the bad apples in the force. Police your own. Because what happened in Minneapolis, what happened in New York, what is happening around the United States is not isolated incidents. These are individuals that are using their powers as a police officer to be judge, jury, and executioner. And that's not how police should be. I'm completely understanding of the sheer amount of anger that is going through Minneapolis right at this point in time. I hope those officers do get charged with murder or I'm not a lawyer. Individuals that, you know, just ignore the murder taking place. There's a specific word for it, but I just can't think of it right at the moment. Today, I just saw a video about the state legislature in Pennsylvania. It infuriates me because there are individuals out there that claim that they're on the moral high ground and are so evil that they willingly put others at risk. Let me see if I can bring this up here. I don't have something here. So let me... not really showing very well. Okay. So... interesting that it's playing the video for this. Just kind of hoping that I could can't really scroll down or anything along those lines. This is not working the way I want it to work at the moment. This isn't working. Here, let me just do display capture. So I'm including the Twitter status here. Yeah, let me go ahead and post it in the post it in chat here, so anyone can kind of see where to go. I'm trying really hard not to get outright political on my channel, okay, because you know, politics, religion, and money are things that the idea of, you know, you shouldn't necessarily talk about them because they tend to bring up high emotions. But I just, this is just another example of things that I don't want to have let stand. Everything that's been going on lately, I don't want to be silent about it. No one should be silent about this. Okay? Everything that's been going on, no one should be silent. Eventually, I'll get onto Terraria and play games that I want to enjoy, relax, and try to escape what's going on in the world around me. But I can't be silent. I'm sorry, I just can't. This is... This is too much. I mean, I've voted Democrat for a long time. I just do not hold to some of the values that some Republicans hold to. And it's because of those choices that Republicans hold to that basically make me not want to join their party at all. You know, that's how my view has always been. Okay. Now, there are some values that Republicans hold that I still think that we can still live with. For example, Second Amendment rights. I have no problem with people wanting to carry, but you have to carry responsibly. Okay? The idiots out there that do not carry responsibility, they are the ones making it difficult for everybody else. And for those of you that do carry, and you see these idiots parading around with their rifles, with their bazookas, you need to call them out. Okay? That is not responsible. Okay? I had an uncle that was responsible with his guns. You know, because he was in the military, he knew how to carry and fire a weapon. He was in the Vietnam War, he knew. Okay? And I trusted him on that. Okay? He kept his guns locked away or directly on his person. He was responsible. And I trusted him on that. These folks that have their fingers on the trigger, that do not have their guns locked away, that keep their bullets loaded in their gun at all times, those are the individuals that you should have a problem with. Okay. And there should be an oversight over it. Okay. I'm not saying get rid of all guns, no. Okay. Because I've seen what responsible gun ownership can be. Okay. You can be responsible. You can be, you know, you can do the right things with the guns if you do it correctly. Okay, I'm a strong proponent of that. Okay, but it has to be done correctly. And when there are people out there that are not correctly, that's a problem. Okay, that's why I'm okay with certain regulations. You know, I'm okay with the background checks, because there need to be nationwide. Period. This video that I'm about ready to show you here is, there's a lot of swear words in it, but I feel that you should watch it if you haven't already.
I sort of don't exactly know where to begin. This morning, apparently, House Democratic leadership learned that for as much as a week, perhaps longer, that House Republican leadership knew that at least one of their members had tested positive for COVID-19, that other members who had been exposed to him would eventually go on quarantine, but they didn't go on quarantine until they were done serving alongside us, especially those of us that serve on the State Government Committee. So for those of you that know, the Pennsylvania House of Representatives, under our gerrymandered Republican leadership, has been perhaps the most active state legislature in the entire country. And during that time period, during the entire COVID-19 crisis, the State Government Committee has been the place where all of these fucked up bills to pretend that it is safe to go back to work have been going. And every single day of this crisis, the State Government Committee in Pennsylvania has met so that their members could line up one after one after one and explain that it was safe to go back to work. It was safe to go back to race car driving or dog grooming or getting your hair cut. Meanwhile, what we're learning is that during that time period, they were testing positive. They were notifying one another, and they didn't notify us. I just spent the better part of the last 11 weeks sitting across a room from people who would eventually test positive and decided not to tell us.
It goes on. This is just one of the videos.
Let me tell you why it matters to me. Let me tell you why it matters to me. I wasn't planning on talking about this until after the election, but in January, I donated a kidney. I secretly donated a kidney to somebody in my city, somebody who lives blocks away from me who was dying of renal failure. I'm so proud of having to do it, but it was not for public consumption. It was for my friends and for my family and for my staff. And every single day that our gerrymandered Republican leadership has been calling us up into this building so they could pass these ridiculous bills pretending that it was safe to be out there, they were covering up that it wasn't safe. You have no idea how the people around you are impacted, and that's why it's so important to notify people. So here's what needs to happen. Here's what I think needs to happen. First of all, Mike Terzai, the Speaker of the House, needs to resign. And any member of leadership that has known what was going on, any member of Republican leadership that knew that members were testing positive, that other members were being quarantined, and did not tell those of us who were exposed to those members, needs to be investigated by the Attorney General. And I think that there needs to be prosecutions. Holy shit. Holy shit, exposing all of us up here to this crap while covering up what was going on while simultaneously telling people, telling families that it was safe to be outside, that it was safe to be interacting with other people while you were testing positive, while you were quarantining the people around you, while you were doing contact tracing and not notifying a single Democratic member who has to show up here every single day for this crap. There is no legislature in the country that has met as much as the Pennsylvania legislature, and there is no committee that has met in this state legislature as much as the State Government Committee. And we have had to listen to this succession of members coming before us, telling us that this was fake, that this wasn't real, that there was no risks, all the while knowing that they were testing positive and withholding that from us.
He's absolutely right. There should be an investigation. Every single one of them should be investigated and prosecuted to the highest letter of the law. If this is indeed what happened in the Pennsylvania state government, then there are members of the Republican Party that were literally infecting their coworkers. Thousand Americans have died because of this so far. And you have this shit going on. It makes me so fucking angry right now. Once I saw that, we go on.
So I've got my eyes right now on the Republican legislature, and there's a bunch of things that I want. I want a full-blown investigation by the Attorney General. Every single member of Republican leadership that knew that this was happening, I want an investigation of what kind of contact tracing that they did. The entire Democratic House of Representatives today had to jump on a call with the Secretary of Health to figure out if it was safe for us to go back to our families. I'm in a building right now surrounded by members that can't go see their kids, that are having to call their husbands, having to call their wives, and saying, honey, I might have exposed you and everybody I love in this world because one of my colleagues tested positive, but he was protecting his family, but not protecting mine, and Republican leadership protected him. I want a full-blown investigation by the Secretary of Health. I need to know if it's safe for us to be back in this building. This building needs to be scrubbed top to bottom. Holy shit. I can't believe that this is happening to me at work today. I cannot believe that this is what we are going through. People always say the parties are the same, or you know, it doesn't matter this party or that party. You know what the difference is? The difference is values and credibility. And every single day that I've showed up at this gerrymandered legislature, I knew that the Republican leadership that was out there was fake and it was false and it was looking out for themselves. But I never, ever, ever knew that the Republican leadership of this state would put so many of us at risk for partisanship to cover up a lie. And that lie is that we're all safe from COVID. That lie is that social distancing isn't important. One of these people, Russ Diamond walked around the House floor every single day without a mask on. Just a little bit ago, I was on the House floor, and at one point, only four Republican members had their masks on. Holy shit. It's not your business to put my life at risk. It's not your business to put the lives of the children of our members at risk, of the spouses of our members at risk.
You can just hear the sheer pain that this man is going through right at this point in time. I'm empathizing with him right at the moment. If I was working in a place's business and I learned that my coworkers had the virus and was willingly exposing other people to it, this isn't some chicken pox. We have it. Chickenpox used to be deadly. There's a vaccine for it. But these idiots don't think. There's no vaccine for the damn virus yet. And they're all like, oh, if you get infected, you're going to be perfectly fine. No, you are not. There's been reports of people getting it again. For a second time. You're going to just keep on getting people infected. The virus is going to change and mutate. Making it harder to make a vaccine for it.
So, Mr. Speaker, all eyes on you. Are you going to continue to lie about your cover-up? Are you going to continue to put lives at risk? Are you going to continue to think that advancing the interests of the big banks and the big business whose pocket you're in is more important than saving lives? Well, you don't get my fucking life. My life belongs to me. It does not belong to you. You had no business putting me and my friends and my colleagues at risk in the way that you have. You're a scoundrel, if there ever was one, Mike Terzai. You have no business in government. You have no business in the private sector. I believe that you should be investigated. I believe that you should be prosecuted. And I believe that you should be in jail. How dare you? So I'll continue to report back. I'll continue to not mince my words. I'm a Democratic member of the Pennsylvania House who just found out that my Republican leadership, in a cover-up to make sure that we didn't know that COVID-19 had breached the House of Representatives, was lying to its members and covering up from its members about that. The only way we found out is because a reporter asked one of our members, and our members got it out of their leadership. You belong in jail. Shame on you. And thank you to everybody that is asking how we're doing and what's going on. The answer is we don't know. The answer is a whole bunch of my colleagues are on the phone right now with their loved ones saying, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for what I might have done to you and not knowing that I did it. And it was Mike Terzai that did it. It was Republican leadership that did it. It was Russ Diamond that did it every single day, slamming a Secretary of Health for saying that it was risky for us to be together every single day, walking around this house without a mask. And where are you right now? You're in quarantine because you might be spreading a deadly disease to all of us and our families. This is shameful. This is disgusting. This is the height of Republican hypocrisy. This is what happens when Republicans gerrymander a state. This is what happens when Republicans take control. Fuck, I have spent so much of my time here trying to see beyond the blind, disgusting partisanship, and now that partisanship has grown deadly. Deadly.
Sorry, folks. I just could not hold to being silent about this. I'm using my platform to spread knowledge about this. To be honest, I don't know whether or not Twitch has a TOS against it. To be honest, I don't really know. Who knows, maybe I just kind of might lose my my channel because of this. But I couldn't be silent. This is affecting all of us here in the States, and I don't want to be silent anymore. If this is indeed what has been going on at the Pennsylvania state government, then this is disgusting. Republicans that are completely ignoring facts about this virus and are willingly infecting others when there's no vaccine is deadly. This pisses me off so much that I just didn't want to be, I didn't want to be silent about it. I'm really, in some ways, I'm trying to keep this channel mainly focused on gaming and the people that also game. Or, you know, those that do programming. You know, the software developers. It's, I mean, I would love to be in a world where I'm doing software development for a living, playing games and maybe streaming in my off time, because that would be pure joy for me. I've done it before, and I would so love to do it again. I hate this timeline. This is the worst timeline for me. People that actively allow themselves to infect others. That is beyond evil. I don't lose my emotions very much. I try to keep it contained, because I want to make sure that people are comfortable. You come to my channel and I give you some amount of comfort, some amount of entertainment to so that you can kind of join me as I continue on in whatever life I have right at the moment. But I cannot condone these individuals that are actively infecting others. I can't be silent. No one should be. If you find that these past 40 minutes is disgusting of these individuals that are actively spreading the virus, then you should speak out too. Be angry and speak out. Now, I'm not one to condone violence. Don't go there. But you hold these individuals responsible. You throw them into the deepest, darkest prisons, and you throw away the key because they deserve nothing less. I'm so angry right now. So many so much crap is going on here in the States right now. And the fact that I've always voted Democrat. Always. There's never really been there's never been a time where I voted for any kind of Republican. I look at their platforms and I hate every single little bit of it for the most part. And to see the country that I've loved for my entire life get to this point where there are members actively infecting other citizens, politicians, people that should know better, people that should, you know, that should be representing us. Pisses me off, man. Really pisses me off. Hey there, Cat King. Hey there, Slade. How you doing? No, I do not love Trump at all. I don't know what Zoom glasses are all about. And thank you for the compliment about the beard. What are we talking about? Well, I posted a Twitter feed. I already kind of played the videos, but I mean, you can find it on my Twitter account if you want to. I can play the videos again if you want to. But this is, I'm kind of upset about it, with everything that's been going on lately, and I didn't want to be silent about it anymore. A lot of shit's been going on here in the States, and I couldn't be silent about it. So I don't know whether or not this violates Twitter to us. I don't know. I'm kind of worried about that personally. Because it's more supposed to be like, you know, entertainment and games and building shit. But these videos really kind of piss me off. Let's face it. There's been a lot of shit going on in the past week or so, going on here in the States, and it's just getting worse, and these videos kind of pissed me off. I just couldn't even get myself cleaned up for today's stream. So, I just combed my hair, threw on a new shirt, and I'm sitting here just talking about what I just saw earlier today, and it's disgusting. Absolutely disgusting. So, I mean, if you want to see this particular, I retweeted this, so you can go to my Twitter account if you want to see the videos themselves. I mean, if you guys really want me to, I can replay them. Or I can replay the videos. I mean, they're not that long, but. GOP leadership hid the fact that a Republican tested positive for COVID and yet still interacted with Democratic members. Here's the other one that kind of pissed me off too. This gentleman donated a kidney to help one of his neighbors out, or to help a friend, or whomever. You know, he doesn't really go into that much detail about it because it shouldn't matter. You know, he helped out another human being, and what does he get for it? He gets individuals that were going around, you know, talking with him, chatting with him, trying to work with him about this. If you're not mad, then you should be. I'm mad, and I mean I don't live in the state of Pennsylvania, so I mean there's not much personally I can do. So most that I can do is, you know, affect what happens in my state. You know, I live on the West Coast. Okay. PST. Pisses me off. I didn't really want to talk about this. You know, my channel is all about, you know, gaming and programming. But I just can't not talk about this anymore. It's, you know, with all the shit that's been going on lately. Minneapolis on fire right at the moment because of the idiotic individual cop. I say individual because there are good cops out there. Okay? I'm not gonna be one of those that say, oh, fuck all cops. No. There are good cops out there, damn it. They just need to police their own. If they see one of their coworkers doing something illegal or problematic, they should stand up and serve and protect to guard against those individuals too. I've said my piece. Sorry for being angry for this short a period of time. Sorry, folks. I'm gonna go ahead and switch over to Terraria now. So be angry. Just don't turn to violence on this. Take action. Take action. Start pulling up Terraria here. I'll switch this over. Apologies to anyone that might have been offended in some fashion or another, you know. To be honest, I don't know how you would be offended by what I was saying, but sorry, I need to kind of blow my nose. Sorry about that. Okay, so let me switch this over.